Now, may I request Dr. Chandan Kachru to please formally introduce our guest of honor for the evening, Dr. Professor Alka Kriplani, ma'am. No, I think it is now Dr. Chandan who can only do that duty.
Ma'am, they have given me 3 papers. I think I can write a book on your achievements. Dr. Alka Kriplani, I think she doesn't need any introduction, but I have to do the formality. So she's ex-president FOCSE, president JSE, president DGES, Delhi Gynecological Endoscopic Society, president AOGD, recipient of third highest, that's a Padma Shri for her distinguished service in medicine by President of India in 2015. She's professor and head department of obstetrics and gynecology, director in charge WHO CCR, HRCC and family planning, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. Her areas of interest are gynecological endoscopy, reproductive endocrinology, high risk pregnancy. Recipient of Padma Shri for distinguished service, as I told you, Dr. B.C. Roy, a national award for eminent medical teacher, honorary FRCOG, Fellowship of Royal College of Obstetrician and Gynecologist in London, and teacher of teachers. Ma'am, you are as good a teacher, as good a surgeon, whatever I have seen, and as good in other co-curricular activities. You have made our existence into, I have no words really. So you better come and welcome Dr. Alka Kriplani.
Thank you so much for your such kind words. President of this PCOS Society, Dr. Dhuru Shah. I have a lot of fixation on Dr. Dhuru Shah because I was really inspired when she was vice president and president of FOCSE. The kind of leadership she has. Dhuru, when you left your presidency for years, go to a smaller city and ask who is the FOCSE president, it is Dhuru Shah. So she is so focused and she has such innovative ideas. See this PCOS society, it is just a toddler society, third year, and it has worked like a senior citizen. So much of work you have done. Thank you so much. And it has given me an insight. All of us who are not members of this PCOS society must become member from Delhi. Because you all are here, because you are convinced that PCOS is such a big problem. Then our chief guest who had to leave because of her busy schedule, that is a very, very important post she is holding. We are in dire need. We endangered species of females. We are struggling and fighting to survive in this male's world and gender inequality. Her post is very, very important. And it's very nice of you to have invited her because they can be of big help, as we heard today, the problem of PCOS and the way they suffer. Every year, I could not attend because both the times I was somewhere else, but the news spreads. And Dr. Madhuri, you are a wonderful scientific person. What I have heard, she goes to each and every minutest detail of the program, and that is how she makes wonderful scientific program. And most important, our team of PCOS, and see, Dhuru, how you give credit to everybody, but two people, Dr. Ragini and Dr. Rita, because they were constantly in touch and working so hard. Believe me, it is nowadays so many conferences are happening. I always say it is easier to get faculty than delegates nowadays. So thank you all for being here, and I think I should not speak much, otherwise the chairs which are getting back, it will be, everybody is in a hurry. But 2-3 things I would like to share, and not to forget my mentor, my teacher, Madam Kamal Bakshi, sitting here. Madam, I'm here today because of you. And I always tell everybody, I was from a very small town. I had just few dreams that I want to do something. It is her graciousness that she gave me a chance to work in All India Institute of Medical Sciences without any recommendation. I had no recommendation, I didn't know anybody, and she just picked me up. Madam, I'm always, and whatever I am today, it is all because of you. My another teacher, Dr. Chitra, is sitting here, and my dear friend Pratima, who is vice president, and they all are from Delhi. Such great people, Dr. Anita Sabharwal, who is has started different kind of leadership, and I'm sorry I don't go into this name game, because if I have omitted some friends, I'm going to get nice beating after this. So everybody is so important. There are two, three things in my mind when we talk of PCOS. Duru, I also started this society 6 years back, National Endocrine Society, because we all who are working closely with these people in endocrinology, we realize that we have to have working in cohesion with dermatologists, cosmetologists, endocrinologists. And today, after listening to that Dr. Girl, I think it is very important, Duru, that we incorporate more counselors and psychiatrists in our society. They play such an important role, because we are on quantity, we have so much of workload. We write prescriptions, but the nutritionist, the psychologist, they are very, very important to deliver what we want to deliver to our patient. Secondly, I feel this genetic is very important. We have to do more research in the area of genetics. It's not that genetics is a written law that your gene, now they have identified on chromosome 2 and chromosome 7. You can modify behavior of genes by changing the lifestyle and weight. And thirdly, when I was going through some literature, something came in my mind. There was a very nice article. If you want to really prevent PCOS with available knowledge and information, you control weight of adolescent girls around menarche. That will go a big way. And fourthly, maybe males are neglecting females. We should not. And all PCOS girls, their brothers, their relatives, they are equally suffering. Not that they can complain of hirsutism and they are having recurrent abortions, but the metabolic syndrome is equally prevalent in males also, which is most important outcome measure. So we should, whenever you are seeing patients of PCOS, we must screen and keep an eye on the male relatives so that we give timely and good advice for more adverse outcome. And I don't want to speak much, but thank you very much for extending this invitation. I didn't deserve to be labeled as guest of honor because I am one of you. And Duru, I am your great admirer, you know, for years. When you were vice president, I came to you. You may not remember that day. Dr. Duru, I also want to come in, Foxy. How should I come in? And you gave me such beautiful. And when you were president, my God, those original ideas, your idea of that training endoscopy that still is going on all over the country. You are a really born leader, and more and more people, we should follow her, like her example, and we should take up. Endocrinology is a subject which is going to bother our patients in a big way, because once you conquer these communicable diseases, maternal mortality, rest everything in obs and gynae is endocrinology. Thank you very much, Ragini and Rita, for inviting me. And thank you all for patiently listening. And I wish this society a great future. And tomorrow I'm going to check, and I'm going to be a member, and I urge everybody to be a member of PCOS Society.